With doubtnit, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnit app today.
Hello students, in this question we need to find the number of real solution of sine e raised to power x equal to 5 raised to power x plus 5 raised to power x, where x belongs to 0 to 1. So from here we have given that sine of e raised to power x, this is basically equal to 5 raised to power x plus 5 raised to power minus x. So let's suppose this equal to f of x and this equal to g of x. So first of all we can solve g of x. So g of x is basically equal to 5 raised to power x plus 5 raised to power minus x. So in this question we have given that x is belongs to 0 to 1. So basically for we can apply AMGM property, which is AM is always greater than or equal to GM. Why we apply? Because here x is greater than 0. So from here we can say that 5 raised to power x plus 5 raised to power minus of x divided by 2 is always greater than or equal to 5 raised to power x multiply 5 raised to power minus of x whole raised to power 1 by 2. So from here we can say that 5 raised to power x plus 5 raised to power minus of x is always greater than or equal to 2. So from here we can say that minimum value of gx, minimum value of g of x, this is basically equal to 2. Now we have to solve for f of x. So f of x function we have given that sine of e raised to power x. So basically f of x equal to sine of e raised to power x. And in this question we have given that x is lie between 0 to 1. So from here we can say that e raised to power x lie between e raised to power 0 to e raised to power 1. So from here we can write as e raised to power x lie between 1 to e. Now, and we know that sine of e raised to power x, it is always lie between minus 1 to 1. So from here we can say that the minimum value of g of x function equal to 2, and here the maximum value of f of x function equal to 1. So from here we can say that there are no intersection point of fx and gx. So fx and gx has no intersection point. No intersection point. So from here we can say that there are no solution. No solution. So from option we can say that option number A is correct. Thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level. Trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download doubtnit app today.